Viral. Being a school-going student, I'm sure you are very well aware about the importance of the rules made by government and would be following that by staying in your houses to protect the country from the adverse effect of coronavirus. Now, I, Gurvinder Kaur, welcome you in the online classes by Mother of Sindhya Public School. In this video, I am going to explain you chapter number 2 of English Literature. The name of the chapter is Nelson Mandela of class 10th. So before I begin with, let me tell you a little about this chapter. This chapter is an extract from the autobiography of Nelson Mandela, which tells about the victory of black over apartheid. Nelson Mandela has told that how the blacks were oppressed by the whites. He has also told that he, that is Nelson Mandela, and his comrades, to whom he has called patriots, had struggled so long to attain the freedom. So students, here is lesson number 2, Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. Introduction of the chapter. The chapter is an extract from the autobiography of Nelson Mandela titled Long Walk to Freedom. In this chapter, there is a glimpse of the inauguration ceremony along with the memories of past. He, that is Nelson Mandela, became the first black president of South Africa on 10th May 1994. He writes that there is no scarcity of gems in his country, he calls the people, but his most precious stones are his own people, where he calls them the black ones. Now, the summary of the chapter. Number 1 point, first non-racial government. It was 10th of May 1994. The day was bright and clear. The inauguration ceremony of the first non-racial government was held at the amphitheater in the Union Buildings in Pretoria, with the largest gathering of international leaders on South African soil. Second is Nelson Mandela's speech on the day of inauguration. Nelson spoke how for decades South Africa was a seat of white supremacy. Now the presence of all people confer glory and hope to newborn liberty. Newborn liberty here refers to non-racial government, means the government which is based on no discrimination between the races. Before this, there was racial discrimination. Whites were the only supreme over there. The victory of black over apartheid was a common victory for justice, peace and human dignity. Now, what is apartheid? It is a policy of segregation or discrimination, that is differences on grounds of race in South Africa. Now the third is policy of apartheid, how it was followed there in South Africa and was abolished after Nelson Mandela became the first black president. Apartheid created a deep and lasting wounds in the people. The decades of exploitation and oppression of the blacks produced heroes like Tambo's, Sizzlers and others. Heroes he is calling to those people who had sacrificed their lives for the fight of freedom. The greatest wealth of South Africa was not in its minerals and diamonds, but in men of such greater character. Such greater character here referring to these heroes only who had sacrificed their lives. Now next is sense of history, which Nelson Mandela felt or recalled on the day when he became the first black president in South Africa. Nelson Mandela was overwhelmed with a sense of history on the day of inauguration. The society based on racial discrimination was the harshest and most inhuman society in the world. Now, with a form of new system, that is non-racial government, based on equality, that is regardless of their color and race, replace the old and cruel system. Replace the old system. Old system refers to racial discrimination system. Now, struggle of comrades, or he called it patriots. Nelson Mandela learned the meaning of courage from brave comrades. These comrades or patriots like Tambos, Sizzlers, Sedus, etc. were ready to sacrifice their lives for freedom and equality. Even in the darkest prison, they were actually oppressed and kept in prison. Their hopes and faith were not broken. Their hopes refers to the people who had sacrificed their lives, and their lives were freedom and equality. They wanted equality in South Africa, means no discrimination between blacks and whites. Now, sixth point is twin responsibilities or obligations. Nelson Mandela feels that every individual has twin responsibilities or twin obligation, that is two. What are those? See, Nelson Mandela thinks that every man has twin obligations. Number one, duty towards his wife, children or family. Number two, obligation to his people and country. But in South Africa, it was impossible for blacks like him, like Nelson Mandela, to fulfill both these obligations. What used to happen actually, if any black tried to live like a free human being, he was punished and isolated. He was forced to live away from his family, live a life of rebellion and secrecy. If any black raised voice against indiscrimination. Next is joining of African National Congress by Nelson Mandela. Nelson realized that not only he but his brothers and sisters were also deprived of freedom. Brothers and sisters is calling to all the blacks over there. That was why he joined the African National Congress. It was his desire for the freedom of his people and their self-respect that totally transformed him, that is Nelson Mandela, a weak young man to a bold one. A law-abiding lawyer was forced to become an outlaw. He knew that freedom is indivisible. He knew that the oppressed must be liberated. And he also knew that the oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. Thus, he wanted or he desired non-racial government in South Africa, which he achieved after many struggles. So students, in this video, I have explained you the summary of chapter number 2, that is Nelson Mandela. And in the next one, I will tell you about the question answers of the same chapter. Till then, take care.